good life, where there's no bosses and no rules, and it's all made possible by Uncle Henry's, a book that we use to make our living, buying, selling, swapping, trading, or as we say, down East Dickering. Codfish, Duke, and I, we've been spending the whole day knocking and talking. Must have something kicking around here. It's a great way to meet your neighbors. How you doing?
Good.
To find out if they've got anything to swap, trade, buy, or sell, or barter.
She's a beauty.
Sometimes we can pick up some odds and ends and turn them over for a pretty decent profit in our old pal Uncle Henry's.
You had about 1,500 in it.
You got 15 in it. Sometimes you strike out. Unfortunately, we're going to have to pass on it today. Sometimes you strike gold. There is an old barn.
Right there.
Right there, buddy.
Yep.
Making the good stuff in there. How you doing, Tony Bennett?
Hi, Tony.
Hi. Chris Caldwell.
Hi, Chris.
Sorry to bother you. We're just out doing a little picking. We come by and fell in love with your place. You had to turn around.
You can take a look in the barn.
Let's take a peek. Well, it looks like old Duke's discovered a new friend. And in that old barn, me and Codfish, we've discovered something pretty interesting. A sleigh, a carriage, and an old horse-drawn buckboard, which is a wagon made for heavy hauling. Here in Maine, with our snowy winters, horse-drawn sleighs, they've been a tradition since the early 1800s. Right now, we're looking at a little piece of Maine history.
The sleighs and wagons my father and mother had, and when they got divorced, my sister got them. She lives in Denmark. Denmark, Maine, too.
Sure. These old sleighs, carriages, and wagons, they're not pulling anyone, anywhere, anymore.
Let it out.
But there's enough collectors out there who would appreciate these for art. So these will definitely sell. So we're going to give this guy's sister a holler in Denmark. Denmark, Maine. And see if she's ready to sell.
Hey, Lynn. I got some people here that are interested in your sleighs and wagons in the barn.
We ran around here and pawed them over pretty good. The old buckboard we like. The sleigh, the bottom of that ain't as bad as we thought it was. The carriage is in pretty bad shape, but it is getting awful punky. You could never use it as a sleigh, but it'd make a nice ornamental piece. Any idea what you'd like to get out of them?
I have no idea. Will they work to you?
Now, the buckboard I like, I'd be in that for around $300. And then the sleigh, I like it. It's getting an awful rough shape, so I'd be in that for probably a buck and a half. And then the one that's in the front, the one with the bad wheels and the bad suspension, another buck on that one. So we'd be talking $550 for the three of them.
Can you go six?
I'd like to stay at five and a half. But by the time I trucked them, I'd have to truck them one at a time. So does that sound like a fair deal to you? And I'll shake his hand?
Okay.
Okay. Thank you, hon.
Alrighty.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
All right, boss. Thank you. Your sister's so happy.
That's worth something. She don't usually be happy.
That's worth something. So we just laid out 550 clams for these old jalopies, and we sure can't afford to eat that cost. Now we gotta hustle, because if there's one thing I don't need, that'd be any more wheels in my driveway. We're taking one out right now. We're going to come back and pick up the other two a little later on. We'll try to pry a cold beer out of you when we come over.
Good luck.
Well, me and Codfish are busy loading up. Clint and Nate, they're ready to chow down and see what's cooking in Uncle Henry's.
Oh, let's see what the day holds today. So what's in here for fun? We can make money. I want to do something fun.
I saw an ad in Uncle Henry's. Pretty sure it's from my good buddy Eric. He's looking for somebody to build a railing in this old cabin I built.
Me and Eric go way back. He wanted a custom cabin built way up in the woods, and I built him a hunting camp. I'm pretty proud of it. It's one of my better accomplishments.
So I decided to give Eric a call and see what this job's all about.
Hey, what's happening?
Hey, not too much. Did you have an ad at Uncle Henry's?
Yeah, I did. I need a railing built.
Oh, in the house that I built up there?
Yep. Gonna have kids up overhead there, and I really need about something up there.
It's starting to sound like the kind of job I can sink my teeth in. He's giving me creative license to do whatever I want with whatever I want. That's awesome.
Be great. You can take on the job.
I'll try to get up there this week and check it out. Thanks a lot.
All right. Catch you later.
Like, that's awesome.
So we're building a railing? What's he paying? Does he say? Does he have any money?
This guy's super generous.
Yeah?
I just built the house and he paid me. He'd say, how much do you want? And I'd tell him. He'd say, that ain't enough. He'd pay me more.
Hell yeah.
I've got to go up and see what I need for this railing. I'm going to go up and size it up. I'm going to take Nate with me. I can't wait to show him this hunting camp. It's awesome.
So you built this thing?
Yeah.
That's cool. Let's go inside and check out the job.
Wow, this place filled up. He wants, I'd say a railing from the chimney to the wall, and then this side of the stairs, this one would bend this way.
I can see why Eric wants a railing here. It's pretty high up. One wrong step, you could topple right over the edge.
What are we going to make it out of? Any ideas?
I think we make it out of trash and turn it into treasure.
Yep.
Eric and I haven't agreed on a price yet on this thing, so I'm going to build it on spec. The more he likes it, the more he's going to pay. So me and Nate got to figure out what to build it out of, and then get busy finding it.
It looks like Clint and Nate, they got their work cut out for them. And a few miles away, Yummy and Mitchell, they're thumbing through Uncle Henry's looking for something that'll bring them a little cash.
This might be it. Right here. It says, for sale. Harley Davidson motorcycles. Three.
Read that again? So he's got three motorcycles for sale?
I guess so.
That's not a whole heck of a lot of information, but people around here love their Harleys, and they're an easy sell, so they're probably worth checking out.
Hello?
Hey, you got an ad in Uncle Henry's for... Is it three motorcycles?
Yes, we do. We got two Harleys, and we got a Victory.
Well, the ad said three Harleys. Now he's saying two Harleys and a Victory. Whoever this guy is, he needs to take a class on writing classifieds.
Where is he?
Where are you?
Well, I'm way up north in Lancaster, New
Hampshire is about 80 miles away. It's going to be about $50 each trip and fuel, so it's going to be an investment just checking these bikes out.
Oh, we're on our way to a happy day.
Well, that was real good.
You guys the one that call on the bikes?
Yeah, we call from the ad and Uncle Henry. I'm Yummy, that's Mitchell.
How you doing, Roger? Pleasure to meet you.
We buy all three of them, right?
Yeah.
I know motorcycles like the back of my hand, and these are great. One is a 1990 Harley Davidson Softail, and it has a lot of extras with it. The other one is a 2001 Custom Harley, has an awesome paint job. The other one's a 2011 Victory, and it looks like it's in really great shape. There's no good reason why these bikes hadn't sold already, except maybe Roger don't know how to sell them. You take six for that one, $7,500 for that one.
I can't do $7,500 on that. It's all been all decked out. I mean, I can sell.
You do $8,000?
Jeez, that's low.
$83,000.
I take $83,000 for it.
Now this one.
Do $11,000?
No. Nope. I'll give you. $8,000.
No, I can't go that low on this one. Best I can do is 85.
I'll flip you. It's $8,000.
Or 85.
Or 85.
Call it in the air.
Heads. Tails.
It's on tails.
Tails. 85.
Right, 85! So, are you guys paying cash?
Let me explain to you how we work. Okay, we don't have much money to work with. So what we do is we barter, we trade stuff around with people and stuff like that. I mean, you've had them in Uncle Henry's for 3 months.
Right.
And I guarantee I'll have them sold within 30 days. Oh, and you can hold the title so I can pay you for the bikes.
That'd be fine.
All right?
Yeah, thank you. I've been trying to sell the bikes on my own, but Yummy made a fair deal, so I decided to go with him.
So we've agreed to act as middlemen to sell these bikes for Roger. He wants a total of $22,800 for all three. Whatever we sell them for above that amount, we get to keep for ourselves. Even though we're 50 bucks in the hole for gas money, this is a great opportunity. We've acted as middlemen before, and it can be a good way to make a good profit. And the faster we get moving, the faster we make the money. We gotta go sell these bikes.
Off on a bright new adventure.
So Nate and I saw an ad for some old wagon wheels and free for the taking. That might be perfect. Building this railing, we're gonna head over there and check it out.
We're shopping for those rings.
Diane, you around?
How are you?
I recognize this guy's wife. She tried to buy a balloon basket off me a while ago.
Do you play poker?
Good
dicker.
I do.
Yeah, I could tell. She wouldn't give an inch.
Out back.
By the river.
If you can find them.
Is that an old dump out back?
Yeah, it was.
Oh, yeah. It's just laying around in the leaves and in the river or whatever. Yeah.
So those out there are just free for the taking.
If you find it and you like it, you can have it.
I can see Diane's not crazy about giving away this stuff for free. Her husband's saying one thing, she's thinking another. I don't know how this is going to wash.
We're going to be here all day, aren't we?
We haven't even started.
Back in the old days, people just threw everything out back. Pretty soon it turned into a dump. And the rusty metal's still all out there. It's a Dickers dream.
I think I found some bulldozer rims. Oh, wow, there's all kinds of crap, huh? Well, I found a saw blade. It's the prettiest dump I ever picked.
Yeah.
You found this, huh? Jeez.
You found this, too, down here?
That was in the dump.
This is some good stuff. Look at the rings. Well, I know my husband said it was free, but I didn't realize all this good stuff was down there.
Thinking, you're very generous.
Well, I'm thinking more around 400 generous.
Wow.
Well, I know my husband said it was free, but I didn't realize all this good stuff was down there.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
You're very generous.
I'm thinking more around 400 generous.
Wow.
Diane's husband said that we could take anything we could find out there for free. And we found some awesome stuff. And now she wants some money.
I think we can make a deal here. I can give you part of it. I can give you some cash. I can't give you 400 bucks. I'll give you 200 bucks.
All right, that's a deal.
Seriously?
That sounds good.
Let's pull it out.
All right.
I'm in the hole $200 on this railing. It's just a spec job. I don't even know how much money I'm going to make on it. So I've got to get really serious and make something really cool out of this stuff.
Thanks, guys.
Well, Clint's in the hole for 200 beans. Yummy and Mitchell, they're about to be in the hole for another 50 in gas money. They got to make another trip to the White Mountains in New Hampshire.
After we placed the ads in Uncle Henry's for $3, I got a call from a potential buyer. So Mitchell and I are on our way over to Rogers to show the bikes. Roger's the guy that owns the bikes, and I didn't want him around under our feet when we were trying to sell them.
How do you say we play a road trip game, buddy?
A road trip game. You know what we used to play with road trip games when we were kids? We used to sit in the back of the station wagon and beat each other up.
Yeah, you want to play that one?
So you're it!
Mitchell?
Yeah, Tony.
Yummy.
What were you asking for him?
For three of them, I'd like to get like 30 grand.
These bikes run and they sound awesome. I know I can sell these bikes to somebody for 30,000. Because these machines are all in excellent condition. They just need a new owner.
Well, you got something you want to trade?
Yeah, that's not really what I was looking for, but still looks nice though, doesn't it?
I mean, sit on it. It's a lot of money, but it's a lot of bike. Those two, that's a lot of bike right there.
Once he hears this kitten purr, he's going to want to give it a new home.
So that's customers on.
So what do you say?
Boy, I don't know. It just seems like an awful pile of money.
Maybe he's more of a dog person.
Think I'm just going to wait on weights back, probably.
Don't want to make trade?
No, everything we got, we want to hold on to.
Okay.
All right, thanks, guys.
Thanks, guys.
This guy didn't even throw out a price. He didn't like those bikes, and there was no way to convince him. It's just a total disappointment.
So that's a waste of a good day, 2 hours up, 2 hours back. So it's a wasted day.
We're into it now for 100 bucks, and we haven't sold anything. This is costing us money, and we can't afford to be keeping this up forever. We need to sell these bikes soon.
All right.
Yummy, he ain't the only one that needs to make a quick sale. Some of us, we're in the same boat. Codfish and me, we're placing an ad in Uncle Henry's for them wagons and sleighs we picked up for 550 beans. And now the phone's ringing off the hook from an interested party. He's a local boy, and he's got a reputation to be a pretty tough dicker himself.
How about a buck 50 for the two?
So we definitely want to be firm about what we're going to end up with out of this deal. We threw in Uncle Henry's for a grand, so we'll start there.
There we are, Duke.
We made it.
There's what you sent me the picture of, huh?
Yeah, that's it. Bring it back, bring it back. There she is.
What's the best we can do on it?
We threw it in Uncle Henry's for a grand. We'd bend a little bit on that. We'd like 900 bucks. $900.
Gee, I was thinking more in the 500.
Oh, my gosh. You just want the real wheels?
Well, you got all the loaders. It's a pain in the butt to load.
Yeah, I told you we shouldn't have loaded. I knew he was going to hit us for that. $500. I knew old Bentley was going to try to beat me up. I didn't know he was going to leave me battered and bruised. Oh, I don't know. We can put it right back in if we got to. I don't want to. We'll go 850.
Well, we're getting better. Hey, 500. I was thinking maybe I'd go up to 6, you know. How about if I buy you guys lunch and a beer? Maybe,
I could use a beer.
Maybe after a beer or something, maybe the price will be better.
We got to finish the deal before the beer. What are you thinking? What's the best you'll do about it?
I don't know. I'd go 7.
That's the best you do, 7?
And lunch.
800, we'll roll it right out back. We'll roll it right out back for you.
I don't know. It seems a little bit high.
You ain't gonna find another one of these for that kind of money delivered.
See, as you deliver it, I'll give you $7.50. How's that? That's a good number. Now, that's a lot higher than I wanted to go.
Old Bentley, he's playing a game of hardball. He's about to figure out me and old Codwell. We've been playing hardball our whole life. I don't know, Bentley. We appreciate you giving us a minute and taking a look at it. We'll bring you something else. Maybe you'll buy something next time. I hate to love this thing, Codwell. All right, old boy.
You're really serious about this? You're not going to sell it to me for the price?
It took old Codfish, Duke, and me about 2 hours to load this butt board up to come up here to see a potential buyer. And now old Bentley, he's playing hardball over $50. But what old Bentley doesn't know is that when it comes to tough negotiations, he's dealing with the guys that perfected the act.
You're really serious, huh? You're not going to sell it to me for the price?
$800 and dinner.
$775 and dinner.
$775 right now, lunch and a couple cold beers.
You got it.
Let's do it.
All right. That's a hell of a deal. How's that?
All right.
That saves us a load.
It's done. Where do you want it? So we paid 550 beans for all three of these, and we just unloaded one of them for $775. We're already 225 beans in the back, and we still got two more to unload. And the icing on the cake is we've got a buyer who's real glad he decided to bend a little.
Come on. Giddy up, go. Giddy up, go.
Now that me, Cod, and Duke are on a roll, we're going to use that $225 to help us trade out. We either might be able to multiply our cash if we end up playing our cards right. I think we're all set. Let's go get one of them cold beers.
Hell yeah.
While me, Codfish, and Duke are at the water hole wetting our whistles, old Yummy, he's cursing the day he ever picked up a cell phone. And give him another minute, and he'll be cussing a lot more than that.
Hello?
Yeah. Yummy, it's Roger again. I heard about it. Did you have any leave?
I agreed to act as a middleman to sell these three bikes for Roger. This guy keeps calling me nonstop to see if anybody's interested. I'm starting to lose my patience with this guy. I'm a businessman. I got other things to do.
Why you keep calling me? Call me every day.
Hey, I just gotta get the bike sold. I need money.
I'll call you when I sell the bikes. Call Mitchell. Call Mitchell. See what he's done.
Hello?
Yeah, Yummy. What's going on?
No, this ain't Yummy. Oh, Roger. How'd you get my number?
I have to give it to you.
Had someone give it to you. Hey, I got a couple questions for you.
What's that?
You give Roger my telephone number?
That's right.
He ain't stopped calling me.
He calls every day.
Well, he's,
two or three times a day.
He's called me three times in the last hour.
You sell the bikes yet? Well, I need the money.
And the other question I got for you is, are you ready to go to New Hampshire?
I just got a call from someone else who's interested in them bikes, and I'm praying they're gonna buy them. Because one more phone call from Roger, I think me and the old man both will blow like a volcano.
Boy, I hope these guys are serious.
Neither one of them got a bike.
I don't know the deal. Hold on a minute. Hello?
Oh, it's you?
No, it's Mitchell.
It's Roger. How you doing on a bike?
Looks like old Yummy and Mitchell have a problem on their hands. Meanwhile, Clint, he's trying to figure out what type of railing to build for his pal Eric's log cabin. He spent $200 on scrap metal, and the question is, now what?
Now that I've got the metal to build this railing, it's time to get creative. I'm glad that Bruce and Nate aren't around, because I go a little crazy when I try to get creative. Man, what a colossal pile of crap. I don't know, I'm not sure where to start. There's just too much stuff. I have to come from the center out. Start is a mounting point and a central point, and that's going to be, cut that right there. That might touch the ceiling. We built the railing from that side. That's the roof. The roof keeps going. So this is the side we're looking at. This will be just a natural bam in the middle. This big hoop isn't even going to fit. It just doesn't quite.
It's looking good.
Well, it just looks stupid. I hate this design. It's just too, I don't know. It's dumb. I'm going to try another arrangement.
Clint goes a little crazy when he starts working on one of his masterpieces. Hopefully he doesn't pull a Van Gogh and cut one of his ears off.
Look at that. That's perfect. That looks awesome.
I don't see it.
It's an eye. How about, let me see. How's that? It's a running man with a wrench and a horseshoe.
Yeah. I was going to say it's a little weird. But
that's stupid, too. What we really need is a wooden spoke right in the middle.
All right.
I need a wooden spoke for this railing. And seeing as how Bruce has a little of everything, I bet he's got just what we need.
So what are you guys doing?
We need round rusty junk. We just need something about this big around.
I got a little bit of stuff here in the barn that you might bar over.
The good thing about having a friend that's a hoarder, they always got stuff.
This isn't that artsy-fartsy crap, is it? Yeah,
no, yeah. Give me back that.
Come on.
That is beautiful.
You like that?
That's exactly what we were looking for. I can't even believe it.
Good luck with the Picasso stuff.
Clint, he's finally got the material to put his notion into motion. But whether that all come together, that's anybody's guess. Meanwhile, old Yummy and Mitchell, they're on the road again.
We just got a call from a father and son who are interested in bikes, and that's great. But the only time they can look at these bikes is early in the morning, and neither one of us had our coffee yet. Hey, what are you doing?
What are you doing?
I told you, I was taking a nap.
Come on, buddy. Keep me company. Don't make me drive by myself. You're my finger trick.
I'm up. Mitchell, how you doing? How's it going?
Good. Mitchell.
Tony.
Nathan.
Pleasure.
Yeah. Tony. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. So this is what we got right here. This is the Softail. It's a 1990.
You thinking of buying this year, son?
Yeah. I want a bike, so.
Well, you both should have a bike. I got, like, a package deal here.
Yeah.
I'm just about ready to make my sales pitch to these guys. And guess who shows up out of the booth?
Hey, guys. How you doing? Hi. Right. Good news?
Oh, man. What is Roger doing here now? He's going to blow this whole deal.
I got Roger. Roger, what are you doing?
What are you doing here, Roger? I'm trying to sell the bikes.
Yummy and Mitchell, they've been playing middlemen to unload three bikes, but they've had a few obstacles to overcome. The biggest one is the bike's owner, Roger. He's been a constant thorn in this eye.
Hey, guys, how you doing?
Hi.
Good news?
What are you doing here, Roger? I'm trying to sell the bike.
I'm just checking, you know, like I said. Well, go check
it out. Roger's like a bull in Yummy's China shop, and I'm afraid he's going to break something.
Don't worry about him.
Don't worry about him. He's got to buy him.
So, what are you looking to spend?
Well,
that all depends
what you're asking.
For this one, I'd like to get, like, 14.5.
14.5. I'd like to sell them today and get them out of here.
Roger,
can you let us make the deal? Who owns these bikes here? Is this guy over here on the bikes?
No, never mind who owns the bikes.
A little too much going on for us, I think.
Because Roger showed up out of the blue, these guys don't know who actually owns the bikes. So that made the whole deal look shady, so Roger blew it.
Have a good day, guys.
Roger, you too. Roger, you can't keep coming over here. I can't sell stuff with you standing there like...
I just want to know what's going up here.
You know, that guy was really interested. Now you scare him off. Roger just cost us another $50. So now we're $150 in the hole, and we haven't sold these bikes. This guy's cost me money, and I don't like it not one bit.
I don't even want to talk to you. Right now, old Yummy, he's in the red, and he ain't too happy. But me and Codfish, we're finally back in the black, and it feels good. We just dragged in 225 clams, unloading one of these wagons we picked up.
We need 75. And dinner.
775 right now, lunch and a couple cold beers.
You got it.
And obviously, we're looking to make a little more by trading out. So when we spotted this ad for a local estate sale, we knew we had to hit it. A good estate sale can be a honey hole of items worth a lot more than anybody could ever guess. There's a lot of great stuff to be found here. An old Alto outboard motor, for one thing.
This is early 30s Caldwell, for sure. The Super Alto Speedster.
The Alto brand of outboard motors was produced from 1921 to 1941. These are definitely old-school antiques, and there's a market for them here in the state of Maine with all of our boating. If we can pick this thing up for a decent price, we stand to make some fair coin.
Ah, Codfish. Look at this money.
In a place like Maine, these old lures are a status symbol for collectors. A truly antique lure could fetch hundreds, if not thousands of dollars, if you can find the right buyer.
They look at least 20s. They're definitely early. You can tell that box, this box, is pretty early.
Me, Codfish, and Duke, we've already set aside a pile of items we think we can turn over later. We just have to hope the owner's willing to let them go at a reasonable price.
All right,
what's the grand total?
It come to $305 for what's in the pile. You take $250, we load it up and get it all out of here. We were at $305.
No, I'd rather take the $3.
You'd rather have the $3.
I want it out of here, but I want $3.
Yeah. All right, okay. Let's do the three.
Let's do it.
So we walked in today with 225 clams to spend, but we ended up shelling out 300. Ain't that just the American way? Now we're $75 in the red. So me, Codfish, and Duke, we're really going to have to hustle to unload some of these items we just picked up to make up the deficit and turn over a decent profit. This, my friends, is what we call a gamble.
I thought they were fair. I thought the dickering went well.
Thank you, sir.
Okay,
Thanks again. Let's load up, Codfish. Codfish and me, we need to get these items listed in Uncle Henry's and get back into the selling mode. Meanwhile, old Clint, he's getting into the creative mode.
So this would go
dead center, huh?
I'm pretty sure me and Nate have enough stuff to build this railing, and I came up with a pretty good idea, I think. I'm going to build a bike inside this wagon ring. What do you think?
Well, it looks awesome. I think it looks real good. That is the weirdest railing I've ever seen in my life.
We gotta load this stuff up and get up there so we can get back before dark. Oh no! You broke my bike? We gotta load this stuff up and get up there so we can get back before dark. I finally finished this crazy motorcycle inside this ring, but the whole bike part fell out. You broke my bike?
I did.
Now it's taking a whole extra hour to weld it back together again. It looks like it's going to hold together now, so we're going to go show it to Eric.
Well, Clint's on a creative streak. Codfish and me, we're on a mission to unload this old motor we picked up at the estate sale. So we're paying a visit to a good old boy named Bud. I don't believe he's ever met an outboard motor he didn't like. It's always been a pleasure to do business with this old boy.
I'll tell you what I'll do. $175.50.
Let's do it. All right, sounds good. If anybody's going to appreciate this old treasure, it's going to be Bud. And hopefully he'll show his appreciation by piling up the old Ben Franklin.
What do you got here?
Oh, I think you might like it.
Oh, look at that. That's a nice motor.
Ain't that nice?
This is probably a 1929.
Yep.
This is nice shape. It's got nice decals.
Well, that's what I really liked about it. All the way around it, you can read everything so nice.
The tank is not dented or anything.
Right.
And the lower unit is good. The skeg is still on.
I had a feeling I wouldn't have to perform too much of a sales pitch here. Showing Bud an old outboard motor, that's like waving a port shot in front of Duke.
So what do you think you want for it?
I'm thinking we'll get somewhere between $400, maybe $500 for this old girl. But since old Bud knows me, he knows I'm going to start a lot higher than what I'll actually settle for. So let the games begin. I don't know, I guess we were looking maybe 7.5, 7.25.
Maybe somewhere.
Maybe somewhere.
Yeah. Maybe
ain't going to happen here today.
Maybe more like 450.
Ouch.
There's got to be a lot of work done to it.
There's still some expense.
There's a lot of hours if you put in there because you got to take it all apart.
I guess we could bend a little on that. We'd take 6.5 for it.
Well, tell you what, I'll come up a little if you get down a little.
I just did. I just come down to 6.5.
Let's split it right in two. I'll come up another 100, you come down another 100.
You want to meet in the middle at 5.5?
550, yeah. I could do that, providing I could find something to pay you with. I tell you what, I just fixed an inner tube.
Inner tube? I ain't quite sure what Bud thinks we're in the market for an inner tube. That plan, that definitely ain't gonna float.
Well, I could write you out a check on the inner tube. Bounce it all the way to the bank. Or we could do cash.
I think we'll go cash.
All right.
What do you think, Codwell?
Good deal.
After picking up items at the estate sale, we ended up being $75 in the hole. But after this sale, we ended up being 475 beans in the black. But we picked up some other good items at that estate sale as well. And we can't rest till we get every dollar we can. And that means Codfish and I, we got to start hustling. We got to get your number again before we leave.
Right.
We need some more of your money.
Yeah.
It warms my dickering heart to have cash in hand. And miles up the highway, Yummy and Mitchell, they're on another long drive to New Hampshire.
and they're hoping to come back with fewer motorcycles and more money.
Wake up. Come on, buddy.
Hey! Come on!
Mitchell. Mitchell, nice to meet you, Dan.
Yeah. Yummy.
How you doing, Yummy?
These are the bikes you called about.
Smooth, no issues with them or anything?
No.
Well, what I do is invest in them, you know what I mean? I'll buy all three and I'll keep one of them for myself, try to sell the other two for what I pay for them. And
what do you do?
I've got a little scrap yard and do pretty damn decent. You take care of people, I take care of you. You know how
that
is?
Right.
That's the way it goes, yeah.
Yeah. Do you mind if I give her a spin?
Go ahead.
Oh, wait, whoa. You got any cash on you?
I'm a phone call away, boss. It's something I like. I don't play around. I don't stutter, so. We'll be back.
It's not weird that he deals in cash only. A lot of people down around here does not deal in banks. But I am a little worried that someone else might have a final say on this guy's money.
Well, it goes nice.
Yeah, if there's
what
any...
What would it take in crisp $100 bills today?
But they got to get about 30 grand for all three of these bikes. But this guy's a little cagey. And I don't know if he's going to be willing to pony up that much.
I was thinking 35. Throw something at me. Say you'd like to trade.
26.5 or something, you know what I mean?
If you come
up. Well, you're almost there.
You're almost there.
Maybe 28.
We're getting there.
Now, if you come up with the right figure, you're going to have a home run plus two extra runs.
Right. 30.
28.5, and I take them. I came in. Like I said, I'm 15 minutes away. Call the old lady up. I could probably have the cash. That's the best I can do.
Oh, here comes the old lady. This ain't good. We're looking at a whole nother dicker, and she might be a tough customer.
We ain't going to have to deal with some pissed off old lady, are we?
Probably. I came in. Like I said, I'm 15 minutes away. Call the old lady up. I can probably have the cash. That's the best I can do.
Yummy and Mitchell, they were right on the verge of selling off those three motorcycles. But then everything came clear. They weren't dealing with the one that wears the pants in the family.
How's it going, Mom?
What do you want?
These are the three rigs I was telling you about.
Did you hear all three of them run?
I have them
take a ride on that one, dear.
Oh, if I would, I knew how to drive one.
No, he's going to take you for a ride.
I'll give you a ride.
I figured once if his wife could get ride on one of them bikes. Women love bikes. They don't care what it is. Mitchell, we just got to work on her.
You're going to have to
talk
her out.
He wants her. It's her. Look, she's smiling.
Oh, really?
She ain't, is she?
Oh, boy.
She don't look too happy, so this deal's not looking good.
What do you say, Mom?
I like this one.
Well, she likes it. I'm going to put her on another one of these bikes just to show her how cool it is. And I'm hoping maybe that's going to seal the deal.
There you go, honey. That's got your name on.
Yeah, it does.
Red and everything.
Red and everything. You look beautiful on that bike. So,
oh,
that deal,
you.
Right?
So
29,000?
30.
29,500?
30.
Now that we got the missus on our side, we're not going to budge an inch.
29,750.
We're stuck, man.
I'm stuck.
Oh, I got the money there, hon, so.
You guys drive a hard bargain here. We've been looking for a victory for almost like 8 months now, and I opened up all clammies and see that in there, and that's just what I was looking for.
Okay. You give that to Mitchell. Go count it.
All right, go get it counted out, see what you got there.
We spent $200 on gas. We owe Roger $22,800 for the bikes. Since we sold all three bikes for $30,000, $7,000 is a pretty good profit. We made all that Roger hassle worthwhile, icing on the cake, and we're going to be Roger free.
Okay, we all good?
Yeah, we're all set.
Okay, good. Thank you very much.
With 7,000 clams in their pocket, Yummy and Mitchell, they're going to be easy riders on Easy Street. And back in Maine, Codfish and me, we're hoping to make a good sale, too. Today, somebody called Caldwell and me about their lures we put in Uncle Henry's that we picked up at the estate sale. With all the collectors in these parts, I think we can fetch pretty top dollar. So now we're on our way to see this guy named Dan. He claims he's an expert on fishing lures. So hopefully he is, and hopefully he'll buy us out.
We got ham, hook, line, and sinker.
Once we lured him in, of course, pun fully intended.
Let's see what kind of treasure you have here. Oh, boy. Well, you got some pretty good lures here. I'd be prepared to pay, I don't know, $400 for them.
Oh, ouch.
Ouch.
Codfish and me, we tried to do our homework.
rare antique fishing lures, they've been known to go for over $100,000. And I'm pretty sure old Dan, he knows that. So $400, that's chicken scratch.
All right, well, I'd be willing to come up some. You interested in any garden tomatoes or anything? I can some of those in?
Codwells are coming on pretty good right now.
All right, well, I'd be willing to come up to $500.
Five you're looking for?
Yeah, I could.
Which two do you want?
Oh! You guys are hot. My God, I thought these guys in Uncle Henry were easy as this.
Sounds like Dan thinks he's dealing with a couple of guys who don't know what stuff's worth. But he ain't, and he'll find out soon enough.
Well, I can stretch it out to six, but six is the most I can do.
You're doing right. You keep coming up.
I'm going to hold right at six. I really feel that's a fair price for these lures.
He seems pretty firm on that 600 figure. But then on the other hand, I'm pretty sure old Dan, he's already on the hook on these lures, and we're going to reel him in.
$800.
$800? $800. We'll get out of here.
I'll bring it up a little bit to $700. How's that sound to you?
Give us another $25, $725, and let us take a half a bushel of tomatoes with us.
All right, you got a deal.
You got a deal?
You got a deal. All right, thank you so much.
We were $475 in the black, and now we're at $1,200. It's been an awesome week of dickering, and now we're going to celebrate it with some good eating.
They drove a hard bargain. They did their jobs, and I'm glad that I have them in my collection now. I'm willing to pay a premium for better quality fishing lures.
Got a few tomatoes out of the deal, Duke. And with a sleigh and a carriage still left in our inventory, the profits are bound to get higher and the week's bound to get better. Load up. Well, Codfish and me are counting our blessings. Clint, he's counting down the minutes until he can show his pal Eric the custom railing he built for the hunting lodge.
Hey, Eric. You couldn't get a hold of him. I'm glad to see you.
Yes.
This is Nate, my future ex-son.
How are you doing, man?
Nate and I built this custom railing for my buddy Eric. He hasn't even seen it yet, and I don't know what he's going to pay, so I'm a little nervous about how this is all going to work out.
You wait till you see what we brought for you.
Good, yeah.
This is just as crazy as that house.
Yeah.
I can't tell if Eric likes this thing or not. If he don't like it, he just did a whole bunch of work for nothing. Different. Different.
Definitely different. I like it. Nice. So that's gonna look awesome.
He likes it. He really likes it. Now the question is, what's he willing to bet?
I like what I see in what you figure.
I'm looking to get $1,200 out of this thing. It's handcrafted. It's totally unique. It's worth every penny. But in order to get $1,200, I'm going to have to start high. I'd like to get $1,400.
What do you think of, maybe $1,200 and a couple days staying here?
Wow. That sounds like a blast,
I'd
huh?
I'd be into that, yeah.
When are you going to be here? Do you want to play, Phil?
Yeah, I'll come up.
That's awesome. We'll meet up here and we'll play.
Yep, yeah, that'll be awesome. A
couple days.
Yes, I'm excited.
Sweet.
Thank you, guys. All right, I'm really happy with it.
Let's go pack up the dirt bikes.
All right.
That'd be awesome.
That looks so good.
We spent $200 on materials for this railing. Sold it for $1,200. That's $1,000 profit. Plus, we got a nice weekend at the lodge.
Guess you're waiting for this. There you go, bud.
That's awesome. Thank
like
you,
that,
sir.
You guys did an awesome job.
Thank you.
You ready?
You might not think of artists living in our neck of the woods. But the truth is, we're all artists here. There's an art to doing good work. An art to having fine friends.
Go get one of them cold beers.
Here you go, buddy.
And an art to appreciating everything Mother Nature lays out in front of you. For us, real artists, they're as common as pine cones. Because we're living down east.